Hello visual effects people, I'm AK and this is Fluid Ninja Live 1.7, and in this video we are going to talk about updated and new content in the project. First, I'm going to the project homepage at the marketplace. Advise you to have a look at the links. We have an updated manual and Live 1.7 playlist, so we have a dedicated YouTube playlist. All new content is being dumped here. And what do we have on this playlist? We have a demonstration of the flagship use case levels, and we have introduction to new features. Manual chapter 29 is introducing the new features, and yesterday I've been creating a video where I go through these features one by one. So in this video I'm not going to talk about the features, but the new content. So here we are, it's the Fluid Ninja Live project folder, and levels are located in tutorials and use cases subfolders. Tutorial per levels and use cases per levels. If you have a look at the level names, you could notice that we have this Live 1.7 name tag. Most of the levels have been updated, and if you open any of these levels, you will find like a short explanation of what's new. For example, this is simulation input level, and we have like 1,000 ways of driving Ninja, but this stage is completely new, demonstrating how particle data could be used to drive the fluid simulation. So this is how levels have been updated, with a name tag and with information text placed at the starting zone helping you. Okay, I'm back at use cases per levels. We have these guys called the coastline demo and the foliage demo, and these levels have been stealing the show completely, so I'm not going to talk about them right now. Instead, I'm visiting one of my favorite updated levels. It is called the Mist Valley. And as a starter, I'm visiting the old Mist Valley because it is included in the project. And you have to know that 1.7 is backward compatible. So this is how Mist Valley looked in the previous version. Notice that we have like a lot of container placed besides each other, and that's how we have been populating areas. Now if I go to the new starting location, it's important to notice that we have only a single simulation and a single volumetric smoke container placed on level. And since this new word space features are enabled, this container is following us all the way along as we move this long corridor, and we don't have to use a multitude of containers anymore to populate levels. And this is very efficient. The performance is like twice as good or three times as good as the original, and this is especially good because this is unlit, which means we are not even using a light source or self shadows. Okay, and we have a lit version, which is 31B. Again, same thing, one container, one simulation. This time we are using this torch or whatever flame thing attached to the pawn's hands as a light source to illuminate the volumetric smoke. So in my opinion, this feature is pretty useful. We have one more related level called Volume Smoke Large Scale, and again it's explaining and displaying how these volumetric smoke containers could be extended and attached to the pawn, or quite the opposite, like we could anchor a component. Just going to the details panel, selecting volume smoke, and you see this anchor volume. If I would anchor a volume, it would not follow the pawn but stick to its original location. Right. Another thing worth to mention is directly set material and directly set position. In case of the volume smoke, you need to switch these on so the container would know that it is running in headless mode and it is Ninja telling the container what's the position and where the data is coming from. So much about volume smoke. Level 33, tutorial level 23, volume fog, has been updated as well. Couple of new things. First, you could use volume fog as a component. And so this pawn is demonstrating how volume fog is added and Ninja is added as a component, both located in the pawn. And please notice these huge, faint gray boxes. This is the volume fog area. It's like a huge box. And if I select this smaller volume here, this is the simulation area. So the point of the whole word space business is that we have a small local simulation area, and our pawn is taking with the simulation area with itself, and wherever we move in the word space containers, we are influencing that thing, be it fog or clouds or smoke or particles. Yeah, let me provide you with another example of the same kind. I'm just randomly jumping between updated levels. We had the original particle levels. I'm going to visit these soon. But so I'm going to use cases per levels, and use case 11 is an important demonstration. The technology is similar. We have the pawn. We have a limited size local simulation container moving together with the pawn. And so the buffers, in this case the velocity, is forwarded to the particle system. And so we have a couple of levels which demonstrate this same technology. Just quickly sampling another one. I would like to focus on this container. Yep. Almost there. So, here we go. These are mesh particles. And it's not only the pawn which is steering the fluid, but all objects which are in the simulation area. As you could see, this red sphere going around and steering the fluid surface and steering the particles. So I'm taking the simulation with me. Yeah, this level is a great place to shift our attention or focus to another feature. So this is stage one. And at this stage, we are demonstrating Simple Painter. Simple Painter is an old feature. It means we are not running a fluid simulation at all. We are just tracking the brush or the object trajectories or bones, and we are drawing that brush strokes and capturing the brush velocity. And so we don't have to run a fluid simulation. It's very efficient. And we could still drive volumes and particles using this technology. Visiting the original Simple Painter level, which is tutorial level 7, you will find the yellow blocks telling you where other Simple Painter examples are. But so here's the original thing, which is explaining what Simple Painter is. And you have seen the particle version. And if you just visit any of these updated levels here and there, you will find that Simple Painter is utilized all along the project. In case we don't want to use fluid simulation, but simply track objects like wheel tracks or footsteps, we are using the Simple Painter for this. Okay, so many levels demonstrating what Simple Painter is. Who's next? Let's stick with the tutorials. Yeah, simulation inputs done, word space done. Niagara, yeah. This is the original Niagara level, and this was the original setup with the fluid simulation. And another new stage here, which is again just simply demonstrating what Simple Painter is and how it could be used. And this is this text is telling you exactly what has been updated. So it's really up to you to explore these levels. Yep. Just an eye candy here. Everybody liked this red sphere back then, almost a year ago. And we have created a new version using Unreal's single layer water material. But it's the same liquid sphere with the new material. That's one thing that we have been trying recently, utilize these existing features in Unreal. Okay, we have seen volume fog and the updated mist valley. How about moving on to use cases? We have seen number 11. And here's a key thing. This is use case package 12 made by Greg Ressler. And this has been like a downloadable content, but now it is included in the project and is demonstrating how particles could be used to drive the fluid simulation. Updated to live 1.7, explained with level placed texts. So we have seen this particle level, the coastline. Well, okay, let's visit use case number 1. These have been heavily updated. Because in the old times it was just a flat surface, and now we're demonstrating how a simple simulation container could populate an infinite area with water. And this level is running with almost 500 FPS on an RTX 3080. So it's like an optimized version, pretty much demonstrating how water could be used on a most simple and efficient way. And we have a wall of text here again with the explanations. Use case level 2 have been updated, same thing like the coastline demo, but in this case we don't have particles, we don't have volumetrics, only two things. One, a simulation managing the fluid surface, and a second one, which is managing the tracks in the sand, which is a simple painter, not a fluid simulation at all. So it's like a simplified version of the coastline, but in turn it's very easy to understand the setups and how things are managed on this level. So in case you would like to understand new technology, this is a good starting point, just like use case level 1. So levels 1 and 2 are like introduction to this thing, because if you visit the complicated use case level, like number 14, it's a lot of things going on. Like we have different containers for foliage and clouds and splash particles and stuff, and it would be easier for you to start with these simple levels with a single container, and so you could pick up what these things are about. Shortly, that's it. Well, we have many of these levels. Yeah, for example, here's the small water bodies level. Again, all stages updated with single layer water material. So we have the liquid sphere, just like on the other level. And we have this, the pool thing. Again, updated to single layer water. What else do we have? Oh yeah, we have these kettles. Again, a single layer water example of a kettle. Let me put it to the steering plateau. Come on. Right on. So this is the updated small water bodies level. And so on and so on. The fire level has been updated as well. Like it's demonstrating not only the old school ways of generating fire, but here's this the new guy, the particle driven smoke and fire stuff. And here we have updated ponds, like this is my personal favorite, stage 9 character effects. We have a volumetric smoke container attached, so the torch is leaving a bit more enhanced smoke. And again, these guys are using the improved word space features. And so on and so on. We have really a lot of updated levels and new content. Worth to check the levels special folder, which, for example, the names are quite telling. Multi-layer material. What am I talking about? Well, we have the simple painter thing, yes. And hey, let me push this big guy here. And it's already introduced in the features, stuff like that. But please notice that this is a very crude and simple example of using the simple painter in. Okay, not the simple painter, sorry. Word space generic output material in a multi-layer material setup, which means I'm simply checking the slope angle and where the angles are too steep. I'm replacing or simply not using the Ninja simulation driven, sorry, the simple painter driven snow material, but instead this flat opaque brown thing. So it's like an example how multi-layer materials could be constructed, and so you could fabricate your own landscapes and only part of it is utilizing Simple Painter or Ninja at all. And yeah, that's it. So again, this levels special folder here. Simulated sand drifts, yeah, that's another favorite. It's like, as you could see, it's preview, so it's not officially released, but it's like it's demonstrating how a fluid simulation. Okay, let me start it once again. In this case, we are not using a simple painter. Do you see the sand surface is moving? And the thing is that we are actually running a fluid sim here to manage these fluids, to manage this surface. And we are also driving a volumetric smoke here. So it's like ideal for creating a sandstorm or a dynamic system, a bit more than a simple painter thing, because we are using fluid simulation and driving multiple systems. So again, it's like an experimental setup. So have a good look around and try to find these sometimes hidden things, and that's it. So I'm saying goodbye. So much about new level content. Ah, one more thing worth to mention. Please visit output materials per base materials. This asset here, a material, Ninja output, word, space, generic, is the single most important asset added to the updated Ninja. Because this is a generic material which is managing sand, snow, water, and all the stuff is built upon this basic material. And so finally, I'm returning to this homepage, and again repeating, please check the links and the updated playlist. That's it. I will get to the details soon with more tutorials. Have a nice VFX time and see you.